Hey everybody, this is Michael again, and welcome back to another video. Well guys, I'm actually late on watching this film. I watched it about a week ago, and I can remember when it was in the trailer stage, and I was watching the trailers, and I was just like, you know, really? I don't want to see another Purge film. And as a matter of fact, guys, my review or my thoughts to the first film are on my channel if you want to go back and watch. I found the first film a well-made film, a well-acted film, but at the same time, I just thought, you know, given the premise of the movie where you have this unique way of telling a story where you have once a year, everybody can go nuts, it's legal, and just do whatever they wanted to do. I thought it was a very, very interesting concept. But overall, my thoughts on the first film was that it wasn't really carried that far to even benefit or really encompass what could really be done with that unique premise. It was a wasted effort with a unique premise. That's basically what I thought about The Purge. And basically, it just became a home invasion film. And I was really, really disappointed with that. It was too personalized. It wasn't big enough. It didn't have enough scope to it. So ultimately, I ended up feeling like it was just a wasted effort that didn't take advantage of a really unique premise. But anyway, we have the second film in the series, guys, The Purge, Anarchy. And I've got my camera out here, guys, or my phone. Well, I guess you could call it a camera, too. But I got my phone out here with some information on the film, guys, because for the most part, all the actors in the film I was unaware of. I don't remember seeing any of them. They might have been newcomers. Or they might have been in other things. I don't really catch a lot of entertainment other than what's on Netflix and what I see at the movies. I don't really catch much television. So some of these actors might actually be television actors or even appeared in some films, but I was not aware of them. Now, this is a film that I feel like is nothing really too different. Nothing really original, nothing really that we haven't seen before in one way or another. But I will say that this is probably the film that should have opened up the Purge universe as far as a series of films go. And there is a third one being made from what I hear. But I think that if this film had been the first film in the series, it would have, in my opinion anyway, capitalized on the premise of The Purge as a whole. And I thought that, you know, watching this film, it was more in line with the kind of film I would want to see as far as this premise goes. You know, you learn more about The Purge, you see it on a bigger scope. It's not so personalized as it was in the first film. They really went for a personalized route in the original film, and I just thought that it didn't. That's not the way they should have went. They probably should have went with this film, The Purge, Anarchy. Even though, you know, it does focus on a personalized vendetta by one of the characters, you still see a much larger scope with the government being involved. You see the effects on the city as a whole, and it even encompasses some of the rest of the United States. So it's a bigger film. Now, like I said, guys, it's not really a movie that you're going to just, you know, it's just nothing you really haven't seen before. So, but as far as the subject matter, The Purge and all that, I think that it was very, very beneficial to its namesake. And I watched this movie, guys, and you know, I gotta tell you that it's a very, very well acted film, and it even, you know, it even surprised me. It's a lot better than I thought it was gonna be. I really enjoyed the film. I really was impressed with the acting, the conviction of the characters, the situations the characters were in. I could feel their frustration, their sadness. The way they did The Purge, leading up to The Purge and going through The Purge, I could really feel the actors' dread for this time of the year. I mean, I'm watching the film, and I'm literally, you know, getting emotionally involved with the cast, getting emotionally involved in how this purge affects people on a personalized level. The first film, they kind of glossed over it. But the second film, this film here, I got emotionally involved with the characters. I felt for them. I felt for their plight. I felt bad for them. And it kind of opened up a bigger amount of feeling in me as for what these people were going through. I got to really give this cast credit for creating that emotional connection to the film and making me feel like these characters were really going through something just terrible. And I really came to really despise this purge and how it affected some of the people who just were so caught up in it that it was really an event they were looking forward to. At times, I got to tell you that it almost seemed like a play on political parties, you know, Republicans, Democrats, and all that. It obviously, I can't say directly what, you know, some of the producers were trying to say with the film, but it's obvious to me that, you know, there seems to be a political connection to the film and the events of the parties today. But I connected with the film, guys. I enjoyed it, and I gotta say, the lead actor, whom I don't remember seeing in anything else, his name was Frank Grillo. Great character in the film, great actor. What I liked about the movie too had a whole lot to do with his character, where he carried the film. He was the heart of the film. Even though he was out on the night of the purge, he still had the humanity in him to help those that were in need. And I kind of admired that about the character. He didn't want to get involved. He didn't want to stop doing what he was doing, but he still took the time to, you know, to let that better part, despite all this purge and people going nuts and crazy, he still had it in him to stand back and help those in need. And I think he's just a really endearing character. He was a beacon of light in a film where, you know, it's so dark and, you know, there's not many people out on the straight and narrow that are really willing to help folks. He was really a really decent character, and I really liked him in this film. Just a character that I really enjoyed. And overall, I gotta say, guys, the film caught me by surprise. It was better than I thought it was going to be. And, you know, if you're not familiar with the purge, you know, once a year for 12 hours, people are allowed to commit any kind of crime, kill, whatever they want to do within a span of 12 hours. And it's legal, they're not gonna get any trouble. So basically, guys, you know, no sense in going over the details in the movie. That's, you have the premise there, and that's what the film's about. And I think this is much better than the first film, and I think it's actually a movie that, you know, I wouldn't mind owning. I enjoyed this film. It is violent at times, but it's also a film that, you know, you sit and watch it, and I don't know if this was intended or not by the producers of the movie, but you sit and watch this film, and you see how crazy people get, and you sit back and you ask yourself, would people really do this? And I was thinking this during the movie. I was thinking, would people really do this? And sadly enough, you know, a little voice in my head saying, yeah, probably. So it's, at times, it's transcends what the producers of the film were trying to say. It actually transcends that and produces a powerful message about human behavior. And, you know, there's a part in the film where some wealthy people actually have people that are unwilling to participate in the purge but caught out in it, and they're actually buying these people, auctioning them off to other rich folks and using them as basically animals to be hunted. So it's definitely a movie that makes you think at times. And like I said, I don't know if it was intentional or not, but The Purge 2 Anarchy is a movie that I did enjoy. Surprisingly, I did enjoy this film. But anyway, that's my thought on The Purge, guys. Next time around, I think I'm going to go back a few years to the 80s and revisit a couple of films that I, or actually three films that I've been wanting to watch since I saw Mad Max Fury Road. That's right, I'm going to revisit all the Mad Max films here and give you my thoughts on those. Thanks for watching, everybody. I appreciate you. Take care, and I'll see you at the movies.